Hello, it's Rachel. Today's project is going to be an altered puzzle piece. The piece I have here is a child's oversized puzzle piece and I've primed it with several coats of gesso before beginning. I've chosen to add paints by PaperArtsy and I'm using three different shades. These are China, Bora Bora and Lilac. Once the paint is dry, I'm going to add some stamping to the piece. I've chosen a Stampin' Up! Background. This one is discontinued, but it is called Love Definition. I've chosen to use Archival Ink in Violet for my stamping. I also wanted to add some stenciling to my puzzle piece, so I've chosen a Crafter's Workshop floral stencil and I'm sponging on ink using a piece of Ranger cut and dry foam. The ink I'm using here is Archival in Manganese Blue. To add some dimensional embellishments to the main puzzle piece, I've chosen these tiny puzzle pieces that I had in my stash. I'm priming them with gesso in the same way I did the main puzzle piece, and then I've selected two of the same PaperArtsy colours to add colour to these. So it's the Lilac and the Bora Bora. To give the tiny puzzle pieces a pearlescent finish, I'm going to add some perfect pearls. So first I'm using a Versamark ink pad and then I'm going to apply the Ranger perfect pearls using one of their brushes. This is a stamp set called Sarah's Choice by Indigo Blu, and I've selected the Inspire Definition text to stamp over my tiny puzzle pieces. The ink I'm using is Archival in Violet. Here I'm preparing my piece for some heat embossing. Again, I'm using a text from the Sarah's Choice stamp set, and I'm inking this up with Versamark ink before embossing it with a black detail powder. To attach my embellishments to the piece, I'm going to arrange them where I'd like them to be and then use Ranger Glossy Accents to adhere them. I decided that I wanted some further stamping on the piece, so I'm using my Itty Bitty Background with some Archival Ink in Jet Black. In hindsight, it would have been easier to do this before I'd put the puzzle pieces down, but at that stage I didn't realise that I wanted more stamping. Next, I'm using some gilding flakes. These particular ones are by Crafty Notion. I'm going to attach these using some glossy accents and a brush to hold them into place. To frame the piece, I'm going to go around the edges with some black archival ink. I'm using a piece of range cut and dry foam to apply this. To finish my piece, I've chosen to add some resin. In this case, it is in Viritex epoxy resin. And once I've poured this on, I use a heat gun to eliminate some of the air bubbles. This resin takes several hours to dry, but it does dry to a very clear and glossy glass-like finish. And here is the end result. This type of project can be used for many purposes. You could attach a magnet to it or a pin back. You could make it into a pendant. It could be a bag charm, or it could also be attached to the front of a mini album or a book cover. So I hope you enjoyed this one. It was a lot of fun to make, and I will see you again soon.